It seems like just about everything is getting an upgrade these days. Our systems are getting smarter, our electronics are getting smaller, our power consumption is going down. Well, yeah, that last one. To properly address power efficiency in our electronic designs, we need to take a closer look at every piece of our designs, from the transistors on up. And heck, we might as well start there today. Hi, I'm Amelia Dalton, host of Chalk Talk. Today, Saravi Karmachara from Maxim Integrated and I are talking about how silicon carbide and gallium nitride transistors are transforming gate driver technology. We take a closer look at Maxim's MAX22700, MAX22701, and MAX22702 family of single-channel isolated gate drivers and see how they can help you with power efficiency and a whole lot more in your next design. And before we get started, don't forget to click that link. There you can find even more information about this topic. Hi, Saravi. Thank you so much for joining me.
Thanks, Amelia. I'm glad to be here.
Okay, so we're talking about improving gate driver technology. But Saravi, why are we looking to improve on gate drivers? I thought what we had was just fine in the realm of gate driver technology.
Well, Amelia, as the saying goes, the Stone Age did not end because we ran out of stones, but we transitioned into better solutions. So the same opportunity lies before us with the energy efficiency and clean energy. So new ideas and innovations have made human evolution possible, as you know, and we are at this information technology age. Electronic solutions are getting really small and more compact by the day, and energy efficiency is needed to be higher. And as energy efficiency becomes increasingly important, the new technologies like gallium nitride and silicon carbide transistors, both being smaller and faster than the current high-power switch technologies, they look perfectly poised to step into this limelight.
So, Saravi, energy efficiency is a lot more than just reducing our overall carbon footprint, right?
Yes, Amelia. So there is a need for reducing the carbon footprint in this world, and we need more energy-efficient devices. And this is what our motivation was in developing our gate driver using the silicon carbide or SiC technology. So SiC helps to bring higher efficiency, compact solution, and also higher robustness. And I'll tell you why. So the new semiconductor materials such as silicon carbide and gallium nitride will be the vanguard of this energy efficiency revolution. So when comparing to a traditional MOSFET and IGBT technologies, these new materials will allow for smaller and lighter components and thereby reducing the cost and energy consumption in applications such as automobiles to solar cell inverters.
Okay, great. Now, Saravi, is this going to help us find a good driver?
Yes, Amelia. So this is a good question. The biggest question is how can we find a good driver, right? So for this, first of all, let's take a step back and talk about MOSFETs. So until recently, choosing a switch technology for a power delivery system was relatively trivial. MOSFETs were commonly used for voltages up to 600 volts, with IGBT being the technology of the choice for higher voltages. However, the lateral crystalline structure of the new power switch technologies, such as gallium nitride and silicon carbide, they offer several significant advantages in terms of performance. And one of their key advantages are that silicon carbide exhibits 10 times dielectric breakdown field strength, also exhibits 3 times the band gap and 3 times the thermal conductivity as compared to silicon. And they are also smaller, allowing higher switching frequencies and increasing switch speeds from like tens of kilohertz to hundreds of kilohertz can increase the efficiency. So they can operate safely at higher currents and temperatures. And this means that they would require smaller transformers and smaller heat sinks, and that allows lighter motors. For example, in electric vehicles, this decreases the size and weight and increases the range. And similarly, reducing the size of the solar inverter makes them more suitable for domestic applications. And, you know, these are some of the reasons that give designers for the switch mode power supplies or inverters more advantage to increase energy efficiency and specify smaller components and also simplify the thermal management to minimize size and also improve reliability. And for this reason, Many switch mode power supply applications are adopting the wide bandgap silicon carbide transistors to improve the power efficiency and also the reliability. Now, however, in order to drive these SiC MOSFETs, we need to have very fast responding drivers that can switch much faster. And the high switching frequency incurs transients that can generate noise and which can disrupt like operations, or they require extensive mitigation. So you can see the noise immunity here is an important factor, and it's technically termed as CMTI, which is common mode transient immunity. So the new power switches which use these materials will place different demands on the components that control them, and that is especially the gate driver. So how can we find a good driver? So the answer is simple. Look no further than Maxim's isolated gate driver, the MAX22700, MAX22701, and MAX22702. These are a family of single-channel isolated gate drivers with ultra-high common mode transient immunity, CMTI of 300 kV per microsecond typical. Our devices are designed to drive silicon carbide or gallium nitride transistors. All devices have integrated digital galvanic isolation using Maxim's proprietary process technology, and we can withstand 3 kV RMS isolation for 60 seconds. And they support the minimum pulse width of 20 nanoseconds and a part-to-part propagation delay matching of only 2 nanoseconds at room temperature and 5 nanoseconds at an extended temperature range. These devices are available in 8-pin SOIC packages. The applications range from general switch mode power supplies that includes inverters, motor control, and UPS.
So, Saravi, what are the specific design challenges we're really trying to solve here?
So that's a good question. So the key challenges that are reported by the power supply designers are that they can't reduce the solution size or increase the power efficiency and reliability and robustness. So these are all related to the robust communication within an industrial environment. And there are like a couple of factors that can help us to overcome these challenges.
Okay, so Saravi, can you explain a bit more about common mode transient immunity? What are we really looking at here?
Sure, Amelia. So this is the first factor that can help to overcome the challenges that we just talked about. The first figure here shows a typical isolated power converter circuit where a low voltage microcontroller is galvanically isolated from the high voltage domain that includes the output switches and their gate driver. So the faster switching speeds mean faster switching transients. For example, for a typical GaN power system, it switches at 5 nanoseconds, and that is an order of magnitude faster than a conventional MOSFET system. And assuming that a typical 600-volt high voltage rail, this results in 600 divided by 5, that's 120 kV per microsecond switching transient. So fast noise transients, they can corrupt data transmission across the isolation barrier, or at worst can cause a glitch that could trigger both power FETs to turn on at the same time, causing a dangerous electrical short circuit. You don't want that to happen. So in order to prevent that situation from arising, fast switching technologies need a gate driver with a common mode transient immunity, CMTI, of at least 120 kV per microsecond for designs using a typical 600-volt high voltage rail in this example. So CMTI is defined as the maximum tolerable rate of rise or fall of the common mode voltage applied between the two isolated circuits. And the unit is normally in kilovolts per microseconds. And high CMTI means that the signal level on either side of isolation barrier is preserved, of course, within our datasheet limits, when the isolation barrier is struck with a high voltage common mode signal. And as you can see, I've listed the feature here. Our part features 300 kV per microsecond typical value for CMTI, which is ideal to drive GaN or SiC switches. And the second factor that you need to watch out is related to the on-off timing of the switches. So in the circuit shown here, under no circumstances should both switches be on at the same time, as this would lead to a short circuit type, usually referred to as shoot-through condition. And to prevent this from happening, the design must allow for a small amount of dead time where both switches are off. However, the GaN switches continue to conduct some current even when reverse biased, and this reduces efficiency as not all power is transferred to the load during this time. And therefore, this is a trade-off to be made between living a sufficiently safe dead time and the reduced efficiency that causes this. So when designing for this type of circuit, a gate driver with the lowest possible propagation delay skew or propagation delay matching is the best choice as it helps to minimize the amount of dead time while also ensuring a shoot-through condition can never occur.
Okay, so Saravi, how exactly does Maxim address those design challenges we talked about earlier?
Amelia, you'll be glad to know that there's a family of Maxim's isolated gate driver IC that solves both the problems, and you get the both solutions to address these challenges. MAX22700, MAX22701, and MAX22702. Our parts come with the highest available level of CMTI, that is 300 kV per microsecond, and propagation delay skew is only 2 nanosecond maximum at room temperature and 5 nanosecond maximum over the -40 to +125 degrees C operating temperature range. This helps to minimize the dead time in your designs and also hence increases the efficiency. The increased focus on energy saving in our daily lives is driving the need to find new ways of making things work. We have learned that SiC and GaN are semiconductor materials which can operate safely at higher speeds and temperatures, and enabling lighter and more efficient designs in different applications. However, these new materials make new demands of the circuit that drive them. I have shown why CMTI and propagation delay skew are the two most important specifications to consider when selecting an isolated gate drivers for application using these switching technologies. And Amelia, I have also presented to you a family of our isolated gate driver IC with both the highest CMTI and the lowest propagation delay skew, making them ideal to use with GaN and SiC FETs in UPS, photovoltaic inverters, and also in motor drives. Hope this helps you to choose the right driver for designing the efficient power supply solutions.
I think it will. So, Saravi, where should my audience go for more information?
Well, I'd encourage the audiences to visit Maxim's website at www.maximintegrated.com. And under isolation, you can find this wonderful isolated gate driver family. We have the IC and EV kits data sheets available. And also there is some additional resources like blogs and a few other things that can help you in your next design. And samples and EV kits are also available.
Fantastic. Well, I think that's all I have time for today. Thank you so much for joining me, Saravi.
Thank you, Amelia, and thank you for your time to learn about Maxim's ultra-high CMTI isolated gate drivers.
And before we go, you didn't forget to click that link, did you? There you can find a whole lot more information about this topic from Maxim Integrated. For Chalk Talks, I'm Amelia Dalton from EE Journal. For more Chalk Talks, head on over to the Chalk Talk section of EE Journal. You can't miss it. It's right across the top. Or head on over to YouTube, youtube.com/EE Journal.